And we are back with Pro Scrims, Complexity versus Curse. And Complexity, they're off to a rather slow start here. They lost the first hard point, then lost the second Search and Destroy, despite having a 4-1 lead.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's a bit upsetting, but you know, you have to get this map. You can't win two maps in one. You know, you have to get it a map at a time. Sometimes when you get down two maps, you try and do too much to try and bring it all back, but you can't bring it all back in one shot. You have to do it piece by piece.
Well, it's going to be one of their better game types, Capture Flag on the map raid, but I want to watch Miracles up the start here. He's the new guy on the Curse Gaming, and right now he's got a lot of map control. Whenever you're on this side and you're able to take control of your enemy's kitchen, you got to be doing something right, but he gets shanked in the back there by Cleister.
Yeah, he got gutted like a fish right there, you know? And Impact was extremely good at pushing kitchen and getting pressure, so you know, Miracles is definitely probably changing that about flag. How Curse plays. And it looks like Complexity's going to pull this flag right up the middle, and they have some pretty good cover.
But here comes Miracles from the back. Aches, he's taking some damage. Going to try running this one inside the kitchen. Krim is there to give him some cover, and Complexity, with around 40 seconds playing the game, they're going to capture a flag, and Aches already has score streaks.
I mean, that's huge. You get a flag in the first 40 seconds and get streaks. That can change the game completely on CTF. You know, and it's going to be interesting how Curse is going to play this. CTF is a game of teamwork. It's all teamwork and rotations and communications, and it's extremely important to know the players you're playing with. So it'll be interesting to see how far their teamwork's come in a week.
Important thing to take note of, these teams are playing without Sentry Guns tonight, so you don't have to worry about that fifth defender in your base. We've seen teams struggle with that all season long. I mean, I ride and die by the engineer Black Hat class, but these guys, they don't want to use it, so.
Well, you know, with the use of so many tacticals by different teams, it's extremely hard to have a class for Black Hat Engineer, because a lot of people, I mean, there are some teams where players like a Crimsix or a Twiz, they'll have a submachine gun classes and AR classes, so it's extremely hard to fit that Black Hat Engineer class in.
Yeah, you only got five classes, so you gotta put your best cards out there, so kind of tough to allot one whole class just to take out a sentry gun. But in the meantime, you got Aches. He's really got the hot hand right now. He's on a 7-kill streak up the start. They capture the first flag of the game, and now he's fully streaked out. He's even acquired the War Machine.
Yeah, you know, you see they're playing a little bit too defensive for my liking. They're stacking a lot of guys in kitchen, not really putting any pressure on Curse, and it looks like there's a guy from Curse sneaking around the back.
Yeah, that's going to be Twiz. Makes the intro kill onto Aches, throws out the smoke grenade, and now he's going to be trying to backtrack here. So trying to put on the juke moves onto Complexity, finds Cleister, but there's one more player over near the balcony. But it looks like that was Crimsix as he gets the kill and the return. And take a look at this. He's using, okay, never mind. That was a little gotcha. I thought he had stock on his submachine gun, but that wasn't the case.
Oh, no, yeah, that would be kind of like pointless. It used to be actually really good, right? Because you had, I think it was plus 150 speed instead of 100.
Something like that. All I know is I still use stock in Search and Destroy.
On your submachine gun?
Yep.
Really? Why is that?
Because I'm always aimed in. You know, I'm always looking at something. So I'd rather, you know, have that extra space speed. You know, I don't really need a quick jar because.
Now, do you use that silence?
Yeah. Online, I do, yes.
Okay, because I was going to say, if you use stock, you don't have to really use that dead silence, I think, because then you don't have footsteps on your aim in sight. So that might be something you might want to try. Mm-hmm.
But in the meantime, you just saw TP put in yet another flag for Complexity. So they started off slow in the first two maps, but they come out guns blazing here as there's still a minute 40 left to play in the first half of Capture Flag, and they already got two flags to their name. As Cleister goes down, take a look at the scoreboard. Aches, he's 9-4 right now. Him and TP both have the flag caps, but it looks like Twiz, he's going to be pulling one for Curse. Cleister is the last one alive. You think Aches is going to use some streaks here off spawn?
And they're all set up, Curse on this flag, and it looks like he is. I probably would have saved these streaks because you're up two flags to none. You can kind of give one away. You don't really, I mean, every flag cap's important, but I mean, to go into the second half up 2-1 with full streaks, I'd take that probably over 2-0 with only a Hellstorm and a War Machine.
Yeah, I mean, especially since his teammates were quite far, they were all off spawn there, but with using that lightning strike there, they were forced to pick up a set of kills if they wanted to get the return, and well, they did it. They got the return there, so I'd say it's a pretty good trade for Aches.
Yeah, it's a pretty good trade. I mean, and it looks like they're getting close to pulling another flag. That's two guys down for Curse, and it looks like they're going to just try and pull this right up the middle again.
Blindfire, last one alive, is able to make one kill there on TP, who was the initial flag runner. Now it's going to be Crimsix picking this back up, and if you're Curse, you can't allow Crim to acquire streaks, and man, he just did it.
You jinx them. Revan's a jinx for everybody with streaks and just flipping cameras, but yeah, that's really fortunate for Curse, and I mean, to give up this flag and have another player from Complexity gets streaks, that's extremely detrimental going into the second half.
Now Krim, he's also going to be working towards another Hellstorm missile after this. So going into the half, Complexity, they have two Hellstorm missiles, a Lightning Strike, and two War Machines. Now, what I'm envisioning here is you're going to have Aches and Crimsix just set up in the back garage, just making a ring with their War Machine on their flag.
I actually think you're going to see them push Kitchen with these War Machines.
They're probably
going
to be
middle.
Aggressive, but still going to be tough for Curse to try to push it and pull flag.
Yeah, it's extremely tough for Curse because now you're going to have to, because of the War Machines, you're going to have to put on Flag Jacket.
Mm-hmm.
So then, if you don't have Lightweight, then you're going to have to run probably Extreme Conditioning, which means,
which means you don't have Tack Mask.
So, you're going to have to pick a way to die, basically, or just a disadvantage for yourself. So it'll be interesting to see how Curse plays this round from a class setup-wise.
And take a look at this. Aches, he knows this. He knows that both of them have War Machines, so he's going to switch over to a double stun class. So very smart pick coming out of Aches here. And his team, they're dominating after the first half. They're up by three flags, and he gets picked off there. But even if Curse captured two flags off the start here, I still think Complexity are going to be feeling very confident in the later stages of the game.
Yeah, and one thing we saw from Curse at the beginning of last game, but we didn't really see as the game went on, is that they started out pushing Kitchen extremely aggressively, and then they gave up a cap and kind of went away from it and started flanking the outsides and overextending it. I think that's why they ended up giving up those two extra caps.
All right, so Krim, he's able to find one there. As you see, he's got some support from Klaser. I'm going to switch over to now. We haven't seen a lot of Klaser, as you know, Aches, he's really been shining, and so has Crimsix. But after Clay comes back from respawn, I want to take another look at him.
Yeah, I mean, Clay is just an explosive player. Once he gets on a roll, he can just keep going, and he always runs that Stealth Chopper now. And if he can get that, I mean, that's extremely devastating to the other team.
Yeah, so if you're out there, you're having troubles with the Stealth Chopper, the way you take it down is either you use a Hellstorm missile, or two Black Hats will take it out, but as we were talking about before, it's kind of tough to allot one whole class to these Black Hats.
It takes two Black Hats to take out the chopper?
Now,
if you have FMJ on, I believe you do more damage to it too. I don't know how many clips it'll take, but that's another way to also take out the Stealth Chopper.
Usually what we see teams do is they'll just switch to the default Rocket class and shoot it down with that if they're struggling with it off spawn, but hold on a second, because we got a flag cap or a flag pull coming from Curse. It's going to be Twist trying to shoot this one down, but the Hellstorm bursts just in time. Crimsix does stop the flag, and Klaser is going to go for a counter pull, puts in the shots, and now Clay, he's going to be working towards the Stealth Chopper. He's got to get past Miracles, who's inside the kitchen, is able to make quick work of him, and I think if he captures this flag, he's going to have it. Well, he gets with that kill regardless.
Yeah, he gets with that kill, and I mean, look at that. I predicted the future. I was talking about the Stealth Chopper. It looks like we're going to see it. And, I mean, right there, Curse had... they had good positioning, but you know, when they got that flag out, they really had nobody else in position to get cut off for the flag, or really in a position to, if he were to die, kind of get the return. So, I mean, to pick it up and keep going with it. So, to pull a flag when your teammates are that far out of position probably isn't the best idea.
Yeah, not only that, Complexity were pretty far pushed up onto the cursed flag, so that Hellstorm missile acted like a couple of rotation kills. They were able to pick up one kill there, and then also another gun intro kill where. All of a sudden, there are two players down for Curse, and Klaser was able to make a flag pull happen there. You saw Twiz trying to switch to the default Rocket class, but the Stealth Chopper mowed him down before he was able to put it to use.
Yeah, you know, I believe they got four guys down, and then I think it was Krim who either lightninged or hellspun directly off spawn. Like you said, it was like two full rotations of kills, so you pretty much just walked that flag in, and it looks like we have another flag being pulled right up the middle again.
I mean, at this point, I don't think there's any way Curse could come back into this game. There are going to be 2 minutes left. They're down by five flags overall. Let's pop up our scoreboard here. 22-12 for Klaser, 22-11 for Crimsix. TP and Aches. Aches was hot off the first half, but at this moment, they don't really have to do much because Klaser and Krim are taking over.
Yeah, Curse is getting, they're getting outslayed this game, but not by much. And it's really just been, I think,
it's
teamwork.
Timely kills.
It's time. Yeah, it's timely kills. It's teamwork. And it's just a little more of, they know how each other wants to play on CTF. That's a huge thing because CTF, it looks slow, but it's actually pretty fast paced. And, you know, if you bring the flag one way or do something that is in your base that it kind of messes the spawns up for everybody else and people aren't aware they need to rotate, then that's when you start giving up these crazy caps.
Yeah, you know, I have kind of like three rules in capture a flag, and rule number one is you always rotate back to your flag. You gotta make sure that your base is clear before you start pushing out on the map and going for some flag pulls of your own. So, you know, rotation, that's the name of the game in capture a flag. And in the meantime, you still see Crimsix, he's got his War Machine to use. Aches looks like he's used his already. No more stealth chopper for Clayster. So really, the only score streak available for Complexity right now is going to be this War Machine.
And do you think the War Machine is more effective than, let's say, the Death Machine or the Stealth Chopper on CTF? What's your opinion on that?
I think, without a doubt, it's more useful than the Death Machine. I don't see many uses that...
The Death Machine, I don't see much Death Machine use.
The Stealth Chopper, I guess it all depends. I think the Stealth Chopper would be infinite times more better if you weren't able to switch to that default class.
Right.
But, I mean, especially if the other team have streaks like a Hellstorm, then you can make quick work of that Stealth Chopper. But, I think the Stealth Chopper... It does more damage, like, psychologically.
Right.
Like, oh, it's man, dude, they have a freaking helicopter in the air.
When you see the little icon come up and it's like Stealth Chopper inbound, you're like, oh, man.
Yeah.
And then you're just kind of like, Clay, I don't know what that was. But
that was a failed dolphin
dive.
That was
a failed dolphin dive, right? Yeah, that was kind of lame.
But he's able to put the flag in the end. So Complexity, they win raid, capture a flag, and that's one hell of a way to bounce back after losing the first two maps of the series.
Yeah, I mean, if you're going to bounce back from losing two maps, especially up 4-1 rounds, that's a good way to bounce back. And those are types of games where you want to set the tone. You want to say, hey, look, we're not going away. We're going to beat you pretty bad, and you're still going to have to sit here and win another two maps.
Clayster, he's normally not the objective guy for Complexity, but... In this capture flag, he had three caps to his name.
Yeah, I mean, capture the flag, it's everyone's got to do objective and capture the flag. I mean, if you can't really win capture the flag with just having one guy going in for pulls and just kind of setting it up, because you're never in position all the time. So capture the flag is not really much of one objective player type of game.
In the end, it's all about your teamwork. Teamwork, it makes dream work, Mr. X.
It does.
So we're going to head to a quick commercial break, but stay tuned because coming up next, it's going to be Hardpoint on Standoff.